Hello, and welcome. In the mid-2000s there was a group who called themselves Crazy Monkey Productions. This group became known by their several century-turning achievements. Their most known achievement was a revolutionary documentary they supposedly self-produced. The group has disappeared from all societal existence. Some speculate they went into the Kakadu jungle and started a self-regulated and free market colony. Some say they purchased an island and have uplifted their strange ways to their own invisible from all but themselves society. For a while the popular theory was, the group had been entered into the Witness Protection Program. This theory has been denied by the US government. We now believe they are secretly the first crew dispatched to explore and inhabit Mars, and we will hear from them if and when their mission is a success. Nevertheless, this documentary was never released. We have uncovered some of the raw footage and have tried our best to make sense of it. Indeed, we have tried our very best. How we've tried our very best indeed. We hope you, the audience, enjoy Crazy Monkey Productions. We wish you the best, and Godspeed you beautiful, ingenious bastards.
Taking documentary.
So come on and jiggity jack yourself before you wreck yourself.
Check.
Yourself, cause I'm bad for your health. I come real stealth, dropping bombs on your moms. Fuck alarms. Do a foul crime, I'm the nigga with your Alpine. Soda 460. Always let tricks know and friends know we got that endo. No, I'm not a sucker sitting in a house of pain. And no, I'm not the butler. I'll cut ya, headbutt ya. You say you can't touch this, and I wouldn't touch ya, punk motherfucker.
This is a documentary, dog. Fuck this shit. Fuck this. I do hard. This is what I do. Right, Jake? Tell them what time it is.
That's right. It's time. It's time.
It's time. Who's the psycho killer name? Matt.
What's
the
psycho killer?
Mike. What, Matt. What's the psycho killer's name?
Merlin?
No, not Merlin. Merlin's a bitch. Fuck Merlin. I'm talking about Christian Bale. Yeah, we got the real American Psycho up in this bitch. I'm telling you, Merlin, if you on motherfucking TV or the internet from prison watching this shit, Christian Bale, motherfucker, and Keanu Reeves. Tell him, Jake, tell him. You want to send him a message. Tell him a message. What would you say to Merlin if...
I need to return some videotapes.
What? What was that? Nah, seriously, Nefs. Return the video.
That's what the...
Rob, come here, man. I gotta ask you something.
Come that's here. What the American Psycho does.
How many hours could you do this?
I don't know.
You don't know? We gonna
find I don't know.
Hey, we're gonna find
I have an accent.
We're gonna get the t-shirt. We're gonna get the t-shirt.
I'm a vampire.
Tell my man. We're talking about Merlin and shit, man, being a killer and shit, man. Tell him what you think about Merlin, man. Fuck Merlin, man. We gangsters, man. He's a threat. Come on, man. Put the city up, baby.
I don't know what time it is.
You were stabbing Jake in the neck with a pen in the side. He was way before.
He was?
Yeah.
He was. He was simulating that shit, dude.
Man, though, y'all ever seen Oz? That's Oz shit. I like that camera, though.
The Tonkin went nuts. To cancel his WWE career, he just went crazy.
It Tatanka!
Tatanka.
Tatanka. Look at that shirt. Oh, the true killer, though. Man, Steve, come here, man. Steve, where you at, dog? Man, we gotta get the killer on tape.
Yeah, come on, kill him, baby. Let's go. All right, signing off. I'm Terry Copple from motherfucking Southside States Interview TV, bitch. And I motherfucking got this brewski, and I'll fuck you up, all the viewers, baby. Let's get it.
Get it, get it, get it.
Woke up this morning after another one of those crazy dreams. Oh, nothing is going right this morning. The whole world is wrong, it seems. Oh, I guess it's the chains that bind me. I can't shake a loose chains and things. Got to go to work this morning. Seems like everything is lost. I got a cold-hearted wrongdoing woman and a slave-driving boss. I can't lose these chains that bind me. Can't shake a loose these chains.
T-Dog.
But you know what I'm saying? I wanted to touch on every subject, like, you know what I mean?
In this experiment, it is essential that there be no outside interference, that the subject's mind be clear to receive the mental message that will be flashed to him.
There's going to be some things that you won't see that you don't want your kids. So put them to bed. Stay up this late for anyway.
You said that is like, that was cool. It's really not so much as
a matter of fact, that was too cool for school.
It's just the cheese.
It's cool. School cold.
Like Marky gets that sliced cheese, so it's cool. Unless it's
a
program.
We
already back.
Matter of fact, the sun's still up. The sun's still up. Put him to bed.
Hello. I'm Orson Welles. Within the cooling systems of atomic reactors, organisms have been discovered flourishing, where radiation could be expected to destroy any living thing.
The reason why I drink Miller Lite so much is because the founder of Miller Lite, he came to me one day and was like, man, why are you drinking? I was drinking Budweiser. He was like, man, why are you drinking that shit? I was like, man. Oh! Somebody just fucking jumped through a wall and fucking hit me. That's psycho shit that happens in my life.
I don't even know what you said, but let's get it.
We thought that this was it.
What's the subject? Hey, yo, what's the subject, baby? We ain't gonna let her take over anything. What's the problem? What the business is? We try to get this money. Yeah, we ain't trying to be talking about all that. We try to get this money. What's good? You tell me. You talking all that? What? What I really want is you to watch me do it. Because I'm the best.
That really made a big impression on us.
We real good. We very good. Yeah, we very, very good. You say very, yeah. Put very in front of me.
Extremely.
Anytime you talk about me.
Extremely.
Yeah. Very, very good.
If there is life out there, intelligent life, how did we ever get the notion that it might be otherwise than friendly? Well, Mars, of course, is the god of war, so the planet bearing his name might be expected to have warlike intentions.
America,
another year of life.
Just doing my thing over here. Drinking a Miller Lite. I don't drink this shit, but hey, it's my B-Day. They got it. Let's get it.
But anyway, back to the story. The reason why I drink so much, because Miller Lite guy came up to me, the owner, he said, like, man, why you drinking that Budweiser and shit? I was like, man, because I ain't never drink beer in the first place.
Hey, what was you talking about, though? Crystal, what was you talking about?
Crystal, baby, man, come on, man, I don't like being mean.
Yeah, what was you talking
but
about, man?
Guess what? I'm be mean to you.
Yeah. Rapping with a deep voice.
I'm saying what you got on.
Archaeologists have discovered amazing similarities in architecture and artifacts in Egypt and at Tiwanaku. Similarities which have led some scholars to suggest that these two civilizations might have a common source. That perhaps Egypt was the principal colony of Atlantis in the Old World, while Tiwanaku was one of the drowned continent's colonial outposts in the New.
If it's good enough for you, why don't you put a glass behind Miller Lite? Because it didn't always have a glass behind it. I said, why don't you put a glass behind it? He was like, you know what, son? That's a good idea. He did it, made billions. I get money from him too. It's in an escrow account. So, fuck it. I'm paid. Everybody good. Everybody who's broke can suck my dick.
This is our explicit shit right here.
Hey,
you know what
for
saying?
15 minutes, this is our 20 minutes right here, man. This is Jungle Hood Dem Radio.
And finally, it would end our social and cultural isolation. To date, we have been bounded not only into our own countries and into our own small regions on this planet, but most assuredly within our solar system itself. If there are the tens of billions of other civilizations which the predictions indicate might be, then we would join a larger galactic community.
No, man, we don't want no music. We don't want no music. We want these people calling in, and we want them to talk to stars.
Psychokinesis, the ability to move physical objects with the force of the mind, is also a subject of intense interest to science and to the military. Here in Leningrad, under strictest test conditions, talented, sensitive Nina Kulagina makes the magnetic needle of a compass rotate by sheer mind energy.
You gotta see this shit. Ah, he brought my CDs. Boom, 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 bam. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
What?
What? That's funny as hell. Hey, Steve, you gotta see this shit, Doc.
What?
Our documentary.
A leading American center of psychic research is the University of California at Los Angeles, where research psychologist Dr. Thelma Moss is experimenting with Kirlian photography, a revolutionary technique invented by Russian scientists Semyon and Valentina Kirlian, which captures on photographic plates the aura or energy field surrounding both organic and inorganic objects.
You got it? I ain't never seen how you be looking into that, man. Did I ever tell you you're a master of your craft? You're the best, you're my brother, and I love you. I tell you that all the time. Let's get this money.
In the past several years, NASA has been allocated millions of dollars for hibernation research as a possible aid to space travel.
I'm taking all shots of brains today, too, man. I'm taking all shots of brains, man. Light them up.
What's the matter? No brains, no beach fucking.
You know what I mean? Hey, yo, we got t-shirts on right now. No brains, no beach fucking, man. You know what I mean? We need brains before you get fucked, man. That's our t-shirts. You know what I mean?
Now, personally, I think it would be a very brave man who would agree first to be frozen alive and then sent out in a rocket to Mars.
So, from this point on, I'm gonna go take a piss.
Tell them to come in and cook that shit they damn soon.
And I'm gonna go up there and I'm gonna take over on the grill.
Let's talk about that today.
Hey, I got on you. I got on you that one time about not playing that new edition joint.
I'd like to make a request. Mr. Telephone Man.
Is it possible, in fact, Mr. Nelson, for people to be cryonically suspended while they are still clinically alive?
Not legally.
I'm off Thursday through Sunday, and I say ooh to the motherfucking week.
Hey, playing
something. Twilight Radio, what do we call it?
Twilight.
Hey, what do we call it? What do we call it? We call it anything that we on. That's what we do. I'm just saying, get this.
He ain't on right now. My phone's off.
The very definite possibility exists that in the foreseeable future, it will be possible to clone the most complex mammal of all, man himself.
I was in Vietnam.
What'd you need?
All right, anyway, I was in Vietnam.
Nam? Yeah. You were in Nam?
Yeah, back when they used to call it Nam. And this fucking suicide bomber went, well, I'm gonna tell you a long story short. Let me, because I was just about to skip. I was in there dealing with one of these little sweet little Vietnam girls in there and shit. And I wasn't supposed to be there. Because fucking Captain fucking Avery's was in there. He was like, man, you ain't allowed to be fucking with them fucking Vietnam bitches or whatever. And I was just like, man, fuck it. I was away from my family for so long. But anyway, I'm in there and I'm fucking with this Vietnam bitch. And a fucking suicide motherfucker come running in with the bomb strapped to his chest. Something triggered this
reaction. I come around with the sickle. Boom! I sickled the motherfucker. He went like, bam! And I fucking saved fucking a whole village.
We have the theory. We have the scientific know-how. However, some of the very specialized techniques that are required have not yet been achieved.
I put my nasty face on when I hear shit about Whammo. If you want to experience getting shot in the head, put your head right here. I'm gonna put my gun up. Bang! Fuck it. Let's get this money.
But there's reason to believe that with the concerted effort, some of the barriers that now exist can be avoided.
And how do you feel about Burger King?
Burger King? I'm the king. Simple as that. Simply said. Fuck Burger.
What do you think about the war in Iraq?
Iraq? I think there should be a war on crack.
Were human cloning finally achieved, and I must emphasize that it has not yet been done.
I'm fucking had Trump. I'm over here with the nigga Crom Needle. I'm over here with the motherfucking nigga Black Heart Set. I'm over here with Matt. I'm over here with Deuce Train, the motherfucking CEO who at them entertainment and shit, man. We over here motherfucking deep right now and shit, y'all. I mean, niggas is feeling it. It's my man Needle's birthday. Yeah, I mean, I ain't gonna say too much about what's gonna go on and shit, you know what I mean?
I think that it would raise some very remarkable ethical problems for all mankind.
That's just because that's what I do.
Original Bridge Kids here. Mm-hmm. Ever since Eddie Barnes used to wear the robe with no shirt on him under it. My nigga Ghost Dini. Ghost Dini's Dallas. You know what I mean?
After all, here would be a group of people who would have no proper father, no proper mother, no family.
He said, Steve think he gonna do something with the pocket knife? He said, Jake, you know what he said about Jake? He said, Jake's cute. You know what he said about Rob? Why he keep wearing that blue bandana? And you know what else he said about everybody else? He's gonna cook them. Maybe Indians eat motherfuckers, I don't know.
Who would recognize from the outset that they were Xerox copies, as it were, of people who exist or had recently existed.
I'm so loyal, you know what I mean? That's gonna be my next dip, you know what I mean? But I also want y'all to work on Black Shit together too, because he got that set up on the first song, you know what I mean?
Seriously though, I've motherfucking seen a motherfucker cut open a motherfucking can of ketchup and drink the shit and fucking squat going to Jane Fonda and squirt the fucking ketchup out their motherfucking ass. I see a motherfucker jump off a roof, land on their feet and slit their throat. Now, who would do some shit like that? I seen that shit. I also fucking been through a motherfucking bank robbery where I was in there and I'm fucking like this with my hands up and shit. And the motherfucker had an AK-47 and he's like, give me your money. He's pointing at the teller and I'm just standing there and I fucking grabbed the motherfucking gun, fucking grabbed him and fucking I put him on the ground like it was some coming to America shit. And then I robbed the motherfucking bank. I didn't get caught. That's true shit, real shit.
Took the money from his cash register and loaded his car up with food and took off for the mountains and left his wife and children at home.
I was fucking working and the motherfucker come in and was like, look, I want a full of cheesesteak. And I was like, all right, what kind of cheese? He said, motherfucker, I got a bomb strapped to my chest. And I'm gonna blow this whole place up if you don't give me a mushroom pepper steak. So I'm just so fucked up about my job. I was like, man, look, I can't do it. He strapped, he pulled his shit out like, whoosh, on some fucking Denzel Washington movie shit. I don't know what movie that was. And he was like, I'm gonna blow it up. And he started speaking this different language. He was like, what did you get? No, woo woo. I was like, man, fuck it. And I pulled the motherfucker,
the designator, whatever they call it, I don't know. It didn't blow up.
The detonator?
Is that what you're saying? Yeah, the detonator. I was like, boom! I pulled the motherfucker because I just was like, thought this was it. He gonna take me any motherfucker. Worry about these cheesesteaks. I'm just trying to feed my family. Yeah, fuck it.
And while it is still very difficult for us to believe that a spaceship landed and that robot-type creatures came out and actually took these two people into the spaceship, these men, in my opinion, believe that they saw this.
I also seen this motherfucking one of my ex-co-workers catch a bullet with his teeth. You ever seen fucking Enter the Dragon? Motherfucker coming here to rob the place. He was like, fuck it, I want money! And just like, boom! His name was John Warnock. I remember. He fucking took his shirt off and everything happened in a split second. He was just like, whoo, and bam!
He came over to me. He asked me, what's wrong, man? I'm thinking he's talking about the beer.
Yeah, I mean, he's talking about some grub. You know what I mean? We talking about that meat. Talking about meat, man.
He asked me for food. This sandwich and snort for hours.
Yes. 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 You said that hours ago.
Anything I love, yes.
I'm coming outside. Once I go outside, I'm outside. I'm done.
Man, nobody don't give a fuck about this place, man.
You
fuck
know,
this
I ain't never seen you in a life beater, dog.
Hell yeah,
you know. I ain't know they made them that big.
Yeah?
They that big.
Yeah,
very soon.
I got you, though, man. I want to mess up the boy's finger, man. I see you didn't think you got it going on, baby.
Hey, we back on. We back on. We back on. This is live. Yo, hey, look.
UFOs first soared into the news in this country in 1947. When pilot Kenneth Arnold saw nine disc-shaped objects skimming along at high speed and in an unconventional manner.
I saved this guy's life. We were standing at the bus stop. It was the first job I ever had. And he was standing at the bus stop. And he looked like he was flustered. I don't smoke cigarettes, but he does. And he was just like, man, this is the last cigarette that I'm ever gonna have. And I was like, man, you shouldn't smoke. Smoking bad, smoking cause cancer. And he was like, no, this is the last cigarette I'm ever had. And I was like, man, what the fuck is wrong with this guy? You know, I just came home from prison and shit. Fuck it, fuck it. You know what I mean? I said, I ain't ready for this type of shit. He went to puff that last smoking a cigarette because something from up above fucking came down to me and said, stop him. I snatched the cigarette out this dude's hand. It was in slow motion. I was like, no. I grabbed the motherfucker up square. Boom! The cigarette was fucking some titanium shit. Like a bomb. He would have puffed that square one time. He would have died. Boom! He would have blew his whole body up. So what happened was, I saved his life. And come to find out, he inherited like millions of dollars. And he said that, you know, all I gotta do is call him and I get everything I want. That's why I just work for fun. Because I know that he got me and my family. Because I saved his life. That's real shit. That's true shit. He's fucking African or some shit like that. I don't know what the fuck he was. Because they all look the same.
A newspaper man who interviewed Arnold coined the term flying saucer. And over a quarter century of sky watching began.
Hey, Crystal, what you think about that? Crystal, be honest, man. You ain't gonna hurt my feelings.
Be honest?
Okay,
be honest.
Don't you like the whole?
Although science has failed to supply a generally accepted explanation of UFOs, the subject has been investigated by the United States Congress. In 1968, Congressman J. Edward Rausch of Indiana chaired the House Committee on Sciences and Astronautics Symposium on UFOs.
I'm a ninja, motherfucker.
Well, wait, let me go past real quick. Hold on. I don't want to, like, get in the backlash of that shit. Like, him pull back and fucking sit bad in the air.
But my imagination tells me that perhaps, just perhaps, there is something that would permit a man to travel faster than light.
One more time, Doc.
No.
One more time, motherfucker. I'm a ninja.
Please don't slip.
They call me the ninja. I can't get it.
perhaps there is something that would permit an intelligent form of life from another planet revolving around another star to make that long trip.
Give me a knife that's gonna motherfucking work.
I'm going hard, man.
Let's get it. Let's go.
We know now that in the early years of the 20th century, this world was being watched closely by intelligences greater than man's. Across an immense ethereal gulf, minds that are to our minds as our minds are to the beasts in the jungle, intellects vast, cool, and unsympathetic, regarded this earth with envious eyes. And surely, drew their plans against us.
And you suck. Signing out, bitch.
Fuck the hoes.